Hi, I'm Michael Janich, and welcome to the Marshall Blade Concepts video series. Marshall Blade Concepts, or MBC, is a system of personal defense that I developed that focuses on the use of edge weapons. It's drawn from the critical elements and fundamental principles of the Filipino martial arts, elements of the Indonesian martial arts, and other edge weapon systems, but it really focuses on modern self-defense. When I first started teaching the system that is now known as MBC back in the late 1990s, I taught using a very traditional methodology. We would typically present flow drills first, reflex training drills that you would practice with a partner, and those drills would teach you specific patterns of motion and sequences of angles. Once you learn those patterns, once you're comfortable with them, what we do is we would draw technique from them and teach you the combative applications. That was an efficient method of teaching, but it really wasn't the best method. What I found once I started teaching, especially in a seminar format and teaching armed professionals, folks like law enforcement personnel, military personnel, and professional security personnel, what I realized is that their need for combative skills was much more immediate. They didn't have time to learn a drill and then learn the application later on. They needed to know the application and understand the application right up front. So what I did was I changed the order of the presentation. When I did, the results we got were spectacular. People understood what was going on. They appreciated the drills more, and their ability to learn and retain information increased dramatically. Now, if you're familiar with any of the other materials I've done on edge weapon tactics, specifically the Fighting Folder series, to put it simply, this video series is designed to make that series obsolete. It's not that the information in that series is bad, it's just that it represents what is now an outdated training methodology. By presenting the information in the current system, so that you're learning applications first and then reinforcing that with the training drills, I find you're going to be able to learn better, you're going to be able to retain the information a whole lot better, and you're going to achieve a higher skill level in a much shorter period of time. So with all that stuff said, let's go ahead and jump into the training. What I'd like to do is review some of what we did in Volume 1 and then show you some other options, specifically as it goes with live hand checking. So our master technique, the primary thing that we learned in Volume 1 and what we built on, if Vince attacks with an angle 1, I'm doing either a pass or a crissada. I then come in, I'm cutting the tricep. We were checking with this hand, thrusting, and then comma cutting that leg. That should look pretty familiar to you based on what you learned in Volume 1. So Vince attacks, I cut this through here, cut that tricep, and when I step and drive, I'm driving 30 degrees that way. What that's going to do is disrupt his balance, put me in a position to where I've got really good momentary control over him. And again, I'm working with a really big surface area here. Notice that when I've stepped in, I'm also monitoring his leg. This is also affecting his balance. I'm fighting with my entire body. Once I'm in this position, I'm now chambered for that angle 3. What I'm going to do is make sure that I step off. Common error you'll see here is people want to go for this cut without moving this leg. Obviously, at that point, you don't know who you're cutting. So I want to make sure that I step off. When I step off, that step is going to allow me to drive with power and clear my leg safely. And now my next vector is 30 degrees that way. Once I thrust in here, I drop this elbow, and now I'm applying pressure. Notice also that I'm applying pressure at a bit more of a downward angle. This is going to stick his foot to the floor. It's hard for him to pull his foot out. I'm dumping full energy into this cut. I cut through, and then I move, and I'm off to safety. So let's take a look at our techniques again. Trainer, trainer, awesome. So let's take a look at the pass for the angle 1. Angle 1 comes in, I step back, I cut. I see that reference point of the tricep there. I cut and check. We know now this is where we want to be. I then step off and cut that quad. That is our master technique. So when you look at learning MBC, you learn that first, and that becomes a foundation for a lot of what we do. So when we talk about deconstructing technique, ideal situation, crissada. I've got both hands working. Everything is working in concert. Second choice, I can't get this hand into play. I simply take a shot with the pass, then fill in the blanks. Third possibility, I can't get my hands going at all on that first motion, and all I do is let Darwin take care of me. Boom, get out of the way. Now I fill in the blanks. That becomes the follow. So what I'm doing is I'm systematically lowering my standards. One of the sayings we have in MBC, like the public school system, when in doubt, lower your standards. What that allows you to do is still achieve functional technique, be able to finish the fight, but realizing that under stress, you're not going to be able to do picture-perfect technique. When we looked at Volume 1, when the angle 4 came in, basically what we're doing is we're cutting and checking with the palm this way. And again, for clarity, what we were doing at the intro level was kind of showing things at range. So from this, I would continue to drive this through, and then I would go for that cut to the leg. Again, that's still valid, perfectly applicable. But there are other things you need to know about this. We've already talked about the idea of that 30-degree vector and the ability to drive with the entire body. So if we add that to this mix, the angle four comes in, we cut and check, and now when I step in, I can still drive with this. And notice that as I do, I'm extending my arm a little bit, still getting Vince way off balance, and he's basically handing me this leg. So this becomes a really powerful cut when I drop that in. In the first volume of the series, Marshall Blade Concepts, the enhanced version, we focused on critical skills, the ideal things that you want to do, the go-to moves that you want to try to apply in a defensive situation. The world's an imperfect place and you need to have a complete skill set. So let's review some of what we did there and then show you the limitations of it. So if we're looking at an angle one, ideally, I want to get to the outside. I want to do that crissata, I want to do that pass, get to the outside because I know that I can follow up and be a whole lot safer there. Angle three, same deal. Crissata or pass, get to the outside, that's a happy place to be. Now in order to do either one of those, whatever my attacker is swinging at me has to be short enough to where I can do this and not get hit in the head. If we replace the knife with some other attack, say a stick, now all of a sudden crissatas don't work nearly as well. So what we have to start looking at is what are our options. Well, one thing we could certainly do based on what we already know is look at the idea of a follow. So he throws that angle one with a stick, I can get all the way out of the way and then dive in and get the back of the arm. But that's a lot of motion for me to be able to get back. If my back is against the wall, if I'm fighting in confined quarters, I may not have that option. So although getting to the outside is ideally where we want to be, again, ideal situation, I wouldn't be getting attacked in the first place. We may have to fight on the inside, and this is where the meats come into play for angles one and three. We've learned the meat for angle two, we've learned it for angle four. Let's take a look at the ones and threes. So when it comes in for an angle one, what I'm doing is actually moving in on this motion, stepping in this way. Let's go ahead and do-si-do for a sec, please. So Vince throws that angle one, I'm stepping in, getting on the inside of the arc of motion of this weapon. I want to move in to where I can target his arm and essentially do all the same things I would do with a meat on an angle two, but just do them on the inside. In Marshall Blade Concepts, the enhanced version, we talked about the basic concept of the MBC system, which is four defensive zones, four defensive responses, four times four, 16 techniques. Conceptually, that all applies. But when it comes to actual application, not all of those techniques are going to give you a clean finish, meaning that they're not going to give you the opportunity to follow through and achieve a mobility kill. That's okay. Let's do a quick review of what we've got, show you where the strengths are, and show you where things still conceptually apply, but they don't give you, again, that finishing technique. When it comes to the crissata, we've got that covered as well. Push-pull, cutting down this way, check, and work the leg. Let's go through that slowly because we haven't covered that in detail yet. This is coming in, we check. This is coming up here, and now what I do is I literally push the arm into the cutting edge. Let's do-si-do and show this from the other side. So this is coming in, checking here, bringing this up, cutting those flexor tendons. And what this also allows me to do now is to draw back and really cook off on that tricep. So the initial motion here, cut, cut. From there, check that arm because I've got the same reference point and go big on that leg. One question I get all the time is, I don't have a partner to train with. I don't have an MBC instructor in my area, so I can't train. What do I do? Train. Get up and train by yourself. Everything that we've just seen demonstrated with a partner, you can also do solo. Yes, ultimately you do want to practice with a partner, find somebody that you can train with, but it doesn't mean that just because the partner isn't available that you have to sit on the couch and not train. So let's take a look at how to go through the same techniques on a solo basis, review them again, and give you the opportunity and the tools that you need to be able to train regardless of whether you have a partner or not. So what we looked at, first of all, was an angle one pass. So it comes in, we step back, we cut. We step in, cut and check, step off, thrust, turn, and then we walk through. So we put that together fluidly, pass, cut, check, and work the leg. One of the sayings I have in Marshall Blade Concepts is you don't have to fight like me, you just have to fight well. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you're able to draw things from it that are going to add to your skill set. So if you ever have to fight, you'll fight well. Train hard and stay safe.